first performance will be from our high school band. Good afternoon. I would like to welcome all of our families, friends, guests, and graduates to this year's commencement ceremony at Annawan High School. What another great year it has been. I am so happy and proud to say that we're all here in person today after a school year of uncertainty, challenges, and ultimately triumph. We are here today giving our students what they need and what they deserve, and we are here today to honor the graduating class of 2022. Today, we will focus on the positive events from the year and from their journey. The past 2 years were not what any of these graduates wanted, but it's what we were able to accomplish. We did this as a group effort. An entire school district came together to keep these students safe, healthy, and ultimately educated. So today, we are here to celebrate the accomplishments of another great school year and are capping off a wonderful educational career at Annawan 226. Before I go any further, I would like to thank a few people who have gone above and beyond this spring to make sure our seniors have a special end to their senior year. A big thank you to our Mayor Tim Wise, Mark Krause, and the Village of Annawan for putting up the senior picture banners displayed on Route 6. Thank you to the parents who helped with that as well. Thank you to Chris Fiddley and Rod Jackson for making sure our venue is ready today and looking great. And to the rest of our custodial staff for having the gym ready to go. Also, a big thank you to Mrs. Heitzler, Mr. Hewlett and Mrs. Wolf for all of their hard work, and thank you to all of you that are here today. It's been a crazy year, and we could not have done it without your support. This year's graduating class selected the class motto from Napoleon Hill. The motto states, "Don't wait, the time will never be just right." Graduates, this is a great quote for your class. First of all, I think we would all agree there's no good time to have a global pandemic. But you didn't wait. You helped the school district persevere and accomplish many great things in the face of adversity. You should be very proud of your accomplishments that each of you have made. I agree that COVID did not make your last 2 years go the way you had preferred, but do not let that be your defining moment. I have no doubt, just like COVID, you will overcome many obstacles in your life. The author of your class motto, Napoleon Hill, went on to say, talking about the quote that you chose, he said, "Regardless of what you plan to do in the future, you should be getting started right now. It is important to take action on your goals and plans, even if they don't seem that important. The best thing you can do is not to wait. Don't wait, the time will never be just right." It is cliche, but it's true. Whatever you plan to do, you have to do right now. Do not wait until tomorrow, because that day will never come. Waiting is the worst thing that can happen in your career. So graduates, as I hope you use the foundation that the Annawan School District has provided you with the strength that you need to get through the obstacles in your life. And please remember that Annawan 226 will always be one of your memories that are forever, will be a part of you. And I hope you can think back to the many great friends, teachers, and staff members who made a difference in your life along the way. Many of you have earned several awards that you should be very proud of. I'd like to take a minute to point out to everybody in the audience, if you look at your programs, you can see we have a lot of graduates who have earned awards and scholarships for their accomplishments. We celebrated them on awards night, but I wanted to take a moment and give them a round of applause again. Definitely well deserved. And graduates, my final message to you this year is simple. Never sacrifice three things: your family, your heart, or your dignity. This quote helps describe this graduating class, because you have already made a lot of sacrifices, but you've worked very hard and have persevered. If you keep your family, your heart, and your dignity as your focus, you will continue to accomplish great things. And I'd like to say this every year to our graduating seniors: remember that the world owes you nothing. You have to go earn it yourself. But I strongly believe your education from the Annawan School District has given you the foundation that you will need to have continued success in your life. So best of luck on all your future endeavors, and congratulations on your commencement.
For all you've done for this school and this community. We are grateful. Thank you. get here, you should all be proud of. I have exposure to people all over the world and in other states, and I can assure you what this community and this school have accomplished is something to be very proud of. I'm going to start today with a quick question. How many of you have ever Googled inspirational commencement addresses? Oh, good. This is good. No one. Good. Don't start now. I have Googled inspirational commencement addresses, and I've also gotten a lot of advice over the past month since you asked me to do this speech, Jared and Matt. Thank you for that. I've gotten a lot of advice. So despite the fact that I have zero children, I can assure you I am fully qualified to give your children advice. People have a lot of advice for graduates. There's a very famous Navy SEAL commencement address in which he has the following advice for graduates. He said, if you want to change the world, start by making your bed. How many of you made your bed this morning? No? You did? No? Okay. I promise you can still change the world. And then there's Oprah. Oprah has given, I think, the most commencement addresses ever. Oprah has a lot of advice for graduates. She said, having a lot of money doesn't make you successful. What you want is money and meaning, said the richest woman in the world. You may not want advice from a Navy SEAL or Oprah, but how about TikTok? If you search TikTok right now for advice for graduates, you'll find hours of advice from thousands of people. There's a TikTok right now that says the following. Feel free to sing along. He said, one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. You didn't sing along. Despite all of that advice, have you ever wondered what they might already know? What if we asked the class of 2022 to give us advice? Well, it just so happens I have an in with the class of 2022. And so I asked them, what advice do you have for all of us? You see, as Matt said, it's the foundation I had when I left Annawan that's carried me farther in my life than anything else. Of course, I've learned things along the way, but it's the foundation, as you said, Matt, that's carried me farther. So today, I'm not going to give you advice. I'm simply going to point out what you already know. So let's start back in third grade. The recorder. Who remembers the recorder? Who was good at, don't answer this, who up here was good at the recorder? Maybe not many. Can we pause for a second and discuss the recorder? Why the recorder? This is not a question of the value of music or the arts. My mother was an art teacher her entire career. I understand the value. But why the recorder? Couldn't we give him an acoustic guitar? The next Chris Stapleton could be sitting up here, and he or she is going to walk out of here and play hot cross buns on the recorder. But maybe it wasn't really about the recorder. The recorder may have taught you teamwork. When you work as a group, you can make beautiful music. Okay, beautiful may be a stretch, but you get my point. You also learn that sometimes, if you stop playing and let someone else play, it may sound even better. It's okay to stop playing and let others play the music. In my current job, I lead a team responsible for just under $2 billion worth of business. And I can assure you most of the time, someone other than me is playing the music. And for some of you, playing the recorder may have taught you that the recorder isn't your thing. Perhaps you went on to be better at sports or math or FFA. After college, I went on to medical school. Turns out, medical school wasn't my thing, so I dropped out. I moved home to the farm that Matt referenced, and I became a substitute teacher right here in Annawan Unit 226. But I kept searching for my thing. And shortly after, I started on the career path that I'm on today. I'm so grateful I learned from Annawan that if the recorder wasn't my thing, if I just kept searching, I'd be okay. Which brings me to my first piece of advice from the class of 2022. Chase Heitzler said, participate in sports. That's his advice. And in essence, what he's saying is, be a part of a team. Know when to stop playing and pass the ball. Jace found his version of the recorder was sports. Good advice, Jace. Participate in sports, or music, or FFA. As a class of 2022, Matt already kind of references, you know all about masks and social distancing. You know that masks and social distancing quickly became about way more than masks and social distancing. You also know that saying the word mask in a gymnasium full of people will silence a room and make them nervous trying to see what I'm going to say next. Nice try. I'm not going there. This is about them. It's not about you. But what you really learn from masks and social distancing is resiliency. You know resiliency. When you were limited in your activities, many of you went out and got jobs. Some of you may have discovered a calling to become a nurse from the last 2 years. That is resiliency. You learn that when there is no end in sight, sometimes you just gotta keep going. But some of you may have struggled for the first time in your life and you didn't understand why. You may be asked for help. You still can, by the way. Maddie had the following advice for us. Maddie Rusk. If you're going through a hard time, you have to take time for yourself. It is okay to be selfish. And Grace said, take care of yourself first. That, Maddie and Grace, is resiliency. And I think this is also what Xander meant when his advice was, take your vitamins. You're right, Xander. We should have taken our vitamins. We have to take care of ourselves. While I can't imagine being in high school during the pandemic years, I'll tell you a quick story how the advice Maddie, Grace, and Xander just gave all of us helped me when I needed to be resilient. You're looking at the homecoming queen and valedictorian of the class of 1996. Turns out, nobody really cared. You're also looking at a 43-year-old woman who's never been married. I was engaged years ago to a man who would end up being a real-life runaway groom. He didn't show up. True story. This homecoming queen was humiliated. I wasn't okay, but I was resilient. I kept going. I got selfish, and I took care of me. Good advice, Matt, Xander, and Grace. And eventually, I realized why resiliency matters. When I applied for a job and got a promotion, I moved to my 6th of 8 states. And then just a few short years ago, I met the real love of my life, who's here with me today. There may never be another pandemic in your lifetime. Please don't let there be another pandemic in your lifetime. You may never have to wear another mask, and you likely won't have a runaway bride or groom. If you do, it's okay. Maybe you will be the runaway bride or groom. That's okay too. But as Maddie said, you'll go through other hard times. But your high school years taught you resiliency, and you will emerge better than you were before. I mentioned I was valedictorian, which leads me to something else you'll know very soon. The last time I was ranked number one in the class of 1996 was in 1996. And class of 2022, today is your ranking reset. Today is the last time you are ranked in the class of 2022. Yes, there will always be rankings in life, but like Trey said, you're not the main character in everyone's story. You are the main character in your story. That's a really good point, Trey. So here is your ranking reset. Where will you be ranked in your story? Riley DeMay, you have the following advice for all of us. Have the courage to live a life true to yourself, not the life others expect of you. People may expect those ranked at the bottom today to fail, but tomorrow, you aren't at the bottom. Like Riley said, live your life, not the life others expect of you. Today is your ranking reset. So the last story I'll share about me and my ranking reset was from a job I did just a couple years ago. It was a higher level position at my company, and there were three final candidates in the pool. A woman who had a PhD in neurobiology from Stanford, people, who grew up on a farm in Annawan, Illinois, just north of here, who got a degree from some tiny little art school no one's ever heard of, only to drop out of medical school. If you're wondering who got the job, the correct answer is C, the woman from Annawan, Illinois, who is so proud to give a commencement address today. Why did I get the job? I played hot cross buns on the reporter. In all seriousness, I got the job because I'm the same person today that I was in 1996. I left Annawan with everything I needed, just like you will. I stayed true to myself. Like Jay said, I found my thing. And Trey, I was the main character of my story. Not the one others expected of me, like Riley recommended. I was resilient. I invested in me during the hard times, Grace and Maddie. Xander, I should have taken more vitamins, but I will, I promise. And in that job interview, I was ranked the exact same as the Stanford neurobiologist and the Harvard MBA. I thought I was a long shot, but Parker, you said it well. Don't let anyone tell you what you can and cannot do. Annawan High School class of 2022, I have no advice for you, except to leave here knowing you have everything you need. Go find your recorder. Get selfish when you have to be resilient. Walk out of here with your ranking reset. Go take your own advice. And if none of that works, I suppose try making your bed. Congratulations and thank you.
Choir.
You've all worked very hard and met the expectations that accompany these diplomas with the help of your family, your friends, and staff at AM-26. On behalf of the entire school community, continue to do great things wherever you go, whatever you do, and congratulations.
Xander Eugene Bremer.